Shares of Chinese streaming giant Iqiyi tanking after the company confirmed the SEC is looking into fraud allegations. The investigation comes months after Wolfpack Research published a report accusing Iqiyi of inflating its revenue numbers. Iqiyi is often referred to as the Netflix of China. And by the way, Baidu owns a majority stake in this company. Baidu shares were under pressure as well. Iqiyi says Wolfpack's report contains numerous errors, and the company has, quote, engaged professional advisors to conduct an internal review into certain allegations. Joining us now is the man who published that report back in April, Wolfpack Research founder Dan David. Dan, great to speak with you.
Great to speak with you, Melissa. Thank you for having me on.
The allegations are pretty damning. You stated in your report that they inflated 2019 revenue by between 27 and 44%, that they inflated expenses, basically made up expenses to show that free cash flow, fake free cash flow, was being burned off in order to hide the fraud. Is this a company that goes to zero, or is this just a company that is making a small business look bigger?
Well, it was a fraud from inception, according to our research, which was a year in the making and hundreds of thousands of dollars if anybody wants to know what goes into this kind of research that takes a year. And prior to their IPO, we believe that they were inflating their deferred revenue, which in this space becomes actual revenue. Doing that, they could never really catch up to the fraud that they committed, according to our research, prior to their IPO. So they have to do other things like acquisitions and inflation of content and things of this nature that we've written about in our report.
There's a new rules coming out or expect to come out that would make Chinese ADRs conform with U.S. accounting standards. And are you spending most of your time now going through some of those companies that might face those challenges coming up to U.S. standards? I mean, is that area sort of, you know, rife with potential targets for you?
Well, I think it is rife with potential targets for all of us, but I think it's also interesting that new rules that they have to follow the same accounting standards that we've all followed all along, which is ridiculous in and of itself at face value. I don't think that they're ever going to be able to do that. And Iqiyi, along with some of the other bigger companies, are already looking to bail to Hong Kong. Mm-hmm. I think Iqiyi is going to have to settle this before they do. Baidu will put them under great pressure to do so. And eventually, these bigger companies are going to be all dual listed and have it out. What we're going to be stuck with are dozens and dozens of fraudulent companies that aren't going to be able to list in Hong Kong. And it's going to, you know, total add to the billions and billions of fraud that have been committed on us for the last 15 years.
Mm-hmm. I want to get to some other short ideas, Dan, but just quickly, I mean, you're short Iqiyi. Did you cover your short at this point, or is there some more downside here?
I still have some short on. Mm-hmm. I covered a lot of it, but I do have some short on Iqiyi. I do have some short on Baidu as well, because I don't think that they were unaware of the issues at Iqiyi, even though in their statement today they're distancing themselves from Iqiyi, saying that they're pretty autonomous and that's why they want to get to the bottom of this. I'm not buying that at all. That's not what our research showed. Mm-hmm. So the answer is yes.
Yeah. I want to move on to another idea. It's not a Chinese ADR or anything like that. Inspire Medical, it's a $3 billion company. From the March lows in the markets, this is a stock that's more than doubled at this point, Dan. So what's the reckoning for this one, for this short that you have?
Well, I just don't think that the total addressable market in Inspire Medical is anywhere near what they tout. We've not been able to see that this invasive surgery where you're basically, you know, cutting a hole in somebody's chest and putting a something that shocks your hypoglossal nerve while you're sleeping as a snore remedy rather than using a CPAP. And to say that they have, you know, that kind of total adjustable market has never been true. They've never made their numbers. They're never going to make their numbers. They're a company that exists on fundraising. They'll continue to do that. And the reckoning will be when this pandemic is over, and they can't just blame everything on the pandemic, and they're coming way off their numbers as they always have, they're going to continue to fail. And this is my favorite short, actually. Mm-hmm. I'm not one to have a short for years and years, but I would hold Inspire Medical for a very long time because they're never going to make their numbers.
You have that much conviction. I do want to get to another one, Remark Holdings. And this is a very small company. And usually on CNBC, we have market cap requirements. And you apparently do as well when I listen to the presentation that you just presented just this week on Remark Media. I should be more specific. You say that this company is also fraudulent. And within this presentation, what struck me is that you specifically targeted or went after Dave Portnoy, of course. He's known as sort of the Robin Hood of the day traders these days because of his Davy Day Trader Global. Why did you bother with this company that is so small? Why did you bother going after Dave Portnoy, who you could argue helped individual investors come into this market?
I think he's hurting individual investors in a very big way. He's financially ignorant, and he'll admit that on any given day. When he has a good day, he's a genius better than Warren Buffett. When he has a bad day, well, it's just a clown show and comedy. And there are people out there right now that are not working. They're at home. They're opening up new E-Trade accounts, and they're day trading. And they should not be listening to somebody that is so financially ignorant that he's investing in companies. He has no idea what they do. You take MVIS, the first company that we went after him on, he literally says in a GIF, I have no idea what this company does. They just print money. Well, you know what? They're down 40% from when we went after Dave on that company. And now you have Remark. It's down another 30-40%.
Right.
Who is selling height vision cameras to the Las Vegas Police Department, to schools. That chicken's going to come home to roost. And you look at Inspire MD. I mean, here's a guy that says, hey, I have over 1 million followers. If we all buy, the stock will go up. No kidding, Dave. It's a nano cap. If everybody buys a nano cap, it will go up. But when he sold at the end of the day at 20% profit, the next morning, retail investors took a 20% haircut. So, no, he is not helping anybody. And I don't see myself taking advice from somebody who sits on the beach at Martha's Vineyard, you know, sipping champagne, painting his toenails, giving out stock advice.
Points taken, Dan, but just separately, even just aside from Dave Portnoy, these companies, objectively, in your view, Remark Media, for one, it's a fraud?
I believe they're committing fraud. I do. Mm-hmm. The filings that we have pulled from China show that the operations that they say they have a VIE contractual relationship with, which we don't even believe is valid, do not match the numbers that they have here in the United States. They have $20 million loss more in their books here in the United States than they are showing in their SAIC filing and credit reports in China. How do you reconcile that if they also say that they consolidate those financials?
Right.
That's just simply not true.
Dan, it's great to speak with you. We hope you'll come back. Really enjoyed the conversation.
Thank you very much.
Dan David of Wolfpack Research, again, the firm that triggered the SEC investigation into iQIYI, the Netflix of China.